Hi students and welcome back to the class. We are doing the chapter light reflection and refraction, and in the previous classes we understood the lens formula magnification, and we applied the lens formula and the magnification along with the sign convention concept to do the numerical. And you must practice the numerical yourself, and then if you find any doubt just let me know. So whether it is from the lens formula or mirror formula, numerical must be done by you. Okay, so now we are moving to the next topic of this chapter, and almost we are at the end of this chapter, light. And let's see what topics we have today. So very first we'll talk about power of lens. Before you go for power of lens, very first you should not be confused between the power concept we have done in the electricity chapter and in the work energy chapter in the previous class, 9th. So where we understood power is work done per unit time or electric energy consumed per unit time. Now this has nothing to do with the power of lens. So these two are not so same. The very first thing is you must be clear that power of lens has nothing to do with the work done, nothing to do with the time. So let's understand the concept. So in general we understood that if we have a convex lens or we have a concave lens, what is the basic property we have of the lens? That is, the lens will either converge the ray of light or diverge the ray of light passing through it. We understood that if in general we talk about the convex lens, then a ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis basically converges. So that's why convex lens is also called converging lens. And for the concave lens, we understood that if the ray of light is coming parallel, it basically diverges. Okay, so this lens is also called diverging lens. So overall, so this is the lens, the converging lens and diverging lens that we understood in the previous classes. So somehow the power of lens is based on this concept, that is, the convex lens has the ability to converge the ray of light passing through it, concave lens has the property to diverge the ray of light passing through it, and how much the lens can converge or diverge the ray of light, that will be its power, nothing else. Okay, so we can say overall power of lens is nothing but the converging or diverging property of the lens is called power. But we'll get proper definition, but before that we need to understand it properly. So one thing we know, that is, if we have a thick lens, a convex lens, that will converge the ray of light, no doubt. So let this be a thick convex lens. Okay, another side, let's we have a thin convex lens. Let me draw it also so that it will be very clear. So one side we have a thick, other side we have thin convex lens. So what is the basic difference we have? We know if you talk about the thick convex lens, it will be a part of the sphere also. Even this will be a part of the sphere, this will also be a part of the sphere. But if you compare both the lens, we understood thick lens is a part of the sphere, and for example this is the center of the sphere, and let this be radius of curvature r1. So this radius, let it be r1, this part, this lens is also part of the sphere, and let the center be somewhere here. See, this is r2. Now what is the difference? You see, if we have a thick lens will be basically a part of the small sphere, because here curvature is very high. So if the curvature is very high, it will be part of the small sphere. If the curvature is very less, less curvature, it will be a part of the bigger sphere. So it is understood, if the dimension of the sphere will change, the radius of curvature will change, and accordingly the focus or focal length will change. So we can say here, if we have a convex lens that is thick, we have a convex lens which is thin. So it is understood here r1 will be less than r2. That is, for the thick convex lens, the radius of curvature will be less as compared to the radius of curvature of the thin lens. And we know At the center of this, what we have? Focus. At the center of this, we have focus. And this is nothing but focal length. So let this be focal length F2. Let this focal length be F1. So you understood, if radius is less, focal length will also be less. So F1 will be less than F2. That is one thing we need to understand. The thick and thin lens, how are they different from each other? That is totally related with the focal length. Okay, so I hope this part is clear. Now if you have understood this one, let's go for converging property of this convex lens, taking the two different focus or focus point of the lens. So just take an example. This is the convex lens that we already know. Okay, and let we have a principal axis. Very first, we should have a clear diagram to have an understanding. Okay, so this is my principal axis, and ray of light is coming parallel to the principal axis. Okay, so we know it will converge somewhere from the center. So let me draw this also. We are talking about the first convex lens, which has the focus at F1. Okay, so let the focus be F1 somewhere here, or that's understood. So what will happen to this ray? It will pass through the focus. That we know, that is a property of the convex lens. So this ray of light will pass through the focus. Yes or no? How much bending of light is taking place, that we can identify with the help of this angle. So if we extend the incident ray, if we extend the incident ray forward, what we'll get? This is the angle, let it be theta 1. So here theta 1 we can say is the angle of deviation. That is, the ray has been converged towards principal axis by angle theta 1 as compared to the initial path of the ray of light, that is with respect to the incident ray. Okay, so let it be theta 1. Now let's make the same lens as a thin lens. So this is quite thick. Now I convert this into a thin lens. So now consider here, the lens has been converted into a thin lens. Try to understand the concept. Okay, so this was my lens 1, and now this is lens 2. So we are drawing two lenses together so that we can compare the lenses together. Okay, so now we imagine the second lens we have, which is thinner than the outer one. So what will happen? This lens will have the focus point beyond F1, because thin lens will have more focal length. So you understood, for the second lens, that is thin lens. So this is for thin lens and this is thick lens. So don't be confused. So for the thin lens, since the lens is quite thin, the focus will be far away or beyond this F1, because we know if the lens is thin, it will have more focal length. Simple. So now the same ray of light, when it will pass through the thin lens, it will not pass through F1, it will pass through F2. Why? Because now the new focus point is F2. So let's complete this diagram also. Because only with the diagram we can understand the concept of the power. So now this is the ray, same ray which is passing through F2. So F1 and F2 are the focus point of two different lenses. They are not same lens. So that you have to remember. We are mixing the lenses together so that we can compare in the same diagram. Okay. Now here we can see this is angle theta 2. So theta 1 is this angle, which is nothing but the angle of deviation for the incident ray by the thick convex lens. Theta 2 is the angle of deviation by thin lens. And here if you can see the angles, it is very clearly shown that theta 1 is greater than theta 2. You can see, if this is my F1, and if this is F2, we know F1 is less than F2, but what you see, theta 1 is greater than theta 2. What is the understanding we have? That is, if the focal length has been increased, the angle of deviation has been decreased because theta 2 is less. So we can say now ray of light is bending less as compared to the previous case. You can see clearly in the diagram. So when the focus is close to the lens, the ray is bending somewhere here. When the focus has been shifted away from the lens, now the ray is bending here. So this is having more deviation as compared to the second. So we can say once we increase the focal length of the convex lens, what will happen? The bending property or bending of light by the convex lens will be less. So we can say overall the lens has less converging property, or we can say this lens, which is converging the ray of light less, is having less power. So this is nothing but the power concept. Okay, so I'm repeating again, if you have not understood, if the ray of light will pass through the convex lens, it will finally converge, that is at focus, and with the change in the focal length, the angle by which the ray is bending will change. And it is understood from the ray diagram, that is, if the focal length is less, the ray will bend more as compared to the bending of light when it will take place when the focal length is quite large. So overall, we can say in the first case, more bending of light is taking place. That is, the thick lens has more power to bend the light as compared to the thin lens. And that is how we are able to relate. Less is the focal length, more is the, F1 is here, less one, and theta 1 is here, greater one. So less is the focal length, more is the angle, and vice versa. This is for the convex lens. So briefly, we can say if we have a quite thick lens, the ray will bend very close to the lens. If the lens is quite thin, the ray will bend quite far away. So that is how, here this is my F1, this is my F1, F2 and F1. So F1 is less than F2, and we can see clearly with the increase in focal length, the ray is bending less as compared to the one in which we have less focal length. So from here we are able to understand that overall power is proportional to 1 by F. Why? Because we understood less is the focal length, more is the bending of light, that is, the lens has more power. Simple. More is the focal length, less is the bending, the lens is having less power. And that is the meaning of power, that is overall how much bending of light will take place by a convex lens will be its power, and that will be the reciprocal of the focal length. So in general, power is written as 1 upon F only, that is reciprocal of focal length. So I hope this part is clear. And if you do the same thing for the concave lens, you'll get the same concept. Again, if you have a very thin convex lens, just take an example, the thin lens we have, and we have a quite thick lens. Again, what is the meaning? That is, if the lens is quite thin, let me draw here a diagram so that you will have more clarity. So if we have a very thin lens, then it will be a part of the bigger sphere. If we have a quite, okay, and if the lens is quite thick, it will be a part of the small sphere. So you understood, the thin lens, if the ray of light is coming parallel, it will diverge. So the ray of light will be diverged by the concave lens, and this is the angle by which the ray will deviate. So let this be theta 1 and let this be F1. So ray of light parallel will diverge by the angle theta 1 as compared to the, or with respect to initial ray or the incident ray. Now for this, we know since it is a part of the small sphere, the focus will be somewhere here, let it be F1. So F2 will be quite close to the lens. So the ray of light which is coming parallel to the principal axis will also diverge. And now this is the angle of deviation theta 2. So again, if you can compare, this is F2. So here F2 is greater than F1, but what you see, F2 is less than. So F2 is less than F1, and what you see, theta 2 is greater than theta 1. Again you see, if less is the focal length, more is the angle by which the ray will diverge. More is the focal length, less will be the angle by which the ray will diverge. So we can say overall, again, depending upon the focal length of the concave lens, the ray of light will deviate or diverge. And how much will it diverge? That will be its power. So more is the angle, more will be its power. Less will be the angle, less will be its power. So here also we have the same concept. Power is 1 upon F. So that is all understanding we have. Power of lens is nothing but the ability of the lens. That is how much it will bend the ray of light, or by how much angle the ray of light will change the direction after passing through the lens. More is the angle of deviation you are able to see, more will be the power, and that will be totally depending upon the focal length of the lens. So overall, combining all the concepts, we just get one concept of the power, that is P is nothing but 1 upon F, because overall how much will be the bending, that will be totally depending upon the focal length of the lens, whether it is concave or convex lens. And based on this, we can write down, that is reciprocal of the focal length of the lens is its power. Okay, but in brief, you should know the bending ability of the lens is its power. But we are not using this for a definition. This is just for the understanding. How much will be the bending of light by the lens will be its power. And proper definition we are getting this, that is power is the reciprocal of focal length. So I hope you understood the meaning, you understood the definition. And whenever we are talking about some physical quantity, power, we must have the unit. And since we are talking about power of lens, we cannot write down what, that is not the unit of power. So here we know, that is in general, focal length is a length. So it will be having SI unit nothing but meter, because the length has the SI unit of meter. Therefore P will be 1 upon F is equal to 1 upon M, that is meter inverse. So we can say this is one of the unit of SI unit of power, or we can write down 1 meter inverse is basically 1 diopter, which is written as capital T. So either we can write down meter inverse as the SI unit of power, or we can write down capital D, which is diopter. So now onwards, we'll be using capital D only for the power of lens, that is SI unit of power. So always remember, whenever we are going to find the power of a lens, the focal length must be in meter. If it is given in centimeter, which is most of the cases we have, we must convert that into meter first, and then we take the reciprocal of that focal length, and hence we'll get the power of the lens. So don't be confused here. So one more thing we can write down here, that is, we know power of convex lens and concave lens. So we know for convex lens, F will take positive, that we remember. So focal length can be positive and negative, and depending upon the power will be also positive and negative. So we know for the convex lens, the focal length is positive, therefore power will be 1 by F will also be positive. So remember, the power of convex lens is positive. So wherever you see plus 2 diopter, for example, so plus sign simply says that it is the power of a convex lens. And we know for कॉन्केव लेंस, आई होप यू कैन रीड आउट, एफ इज इक्वल बेसिकली नेगेटिव, एंड इफ एफ इज नेगेटिव देयर फोर पी विल बी 1 बाय एफ, दैट विल ऑल्सो गो नेगेटिव. सो दैट इज अनदर थिंग यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, power of convex lens is positive, power of concave lens will be negative. Always be alert when you do the numerical based on the power of lens. So I hope you understood this much. Let's take one or two numerical and then we'll go for the last topic of this chapter. So overall the chapter is almost over. So let's see the question. If the focal length of a lens or concave lens, better write down, concave lens is 100 centimeter, find its power. So it's very simple, but we should know what is to be done. So very first, what is given? Focal length is given. Now it is a concave lens. So in the statement, in the numerical, it will be given in positive only, but we have to be alert, it is concave lens, so we have to take this as negative. And you know 100 centimeter is 1 meter, so minus 1 meter. We must convert it, otherwise the entire numerical will be wrong. Therefore, P is equal to 1 upon F, that is 1 by minus 1, that is minus 1 diopter. So that is how positive and negative has the importance. If I just change concave by convex, replace it, then automatically this answer will come in positive. And you know both concave and convex lens are not same, they are just opposite, so power must be positive and negative also. I hope you understood this one. Okay, so whether we say P is equal to 1 by F or we say F is equal to 1 by P, both are okay because formula is same. So sometime power can be given and you have to find the focal length. So let's do one based on this also. That is, if power of a lens is plus 4 diopter, find its focal length. So this can be another way of giving the question, that is power is given in plus and now we have to find the focal length, and we understood from here it is plus, so it must be a convex lens. So automatically my focal length should come in positive. So when power is given, if it is in plus, we understood it is convex lens. If somewhere it is mentioned it is convex lens, then we know the power must be positive. So you have to be alert in all the ways. Okay, so here power is given plus 4 diopter. So F is equal to 1 by P, 1 by 4. But this will come in meter. Don't be confused here, because when the power is in diopter, focal length will come in meter. And now we can convert this into centimeter. So multiply by 100, it will be how much? 25 centimeter. So I'm writing here, okay. So then we can convert meter into centimeter. That will be nothing but 25 centimeter. So this is how you have to handle the numerical based on the power of lens. Be alert everywhere, otherwise numerical will be wrong somewhere. So I'm going for the next topic, the last topic we have, that is called combination of lens. Combination is the sense like it is possible we are having a concave lens and with close to this we place a convex lens. It is possible we have one concave and one convex lens, they are placed together. Now when the ray of light will pass through this combination, this is now combined lens. So this is now combined lens because they are placed very close to each other. Now this will too merge together and now it will behave as a single lens. So overall the entire property will change, because now where we have concave lens, we have convex lens. Convex lens can have different focal length, concave lens can have different focal length, but once they are placed together, the ray of light first, it will try to diverge, then it will converge. So it will have deviation many times, okay. So automatically the ray which is coming out can be a kind of converging, can be a kind of diverging, depends on how we have placed the two lenses together. This is one possibility we have, that is concave and convex can be placed together. It is also possible that two different convex lenses are placed very close to each other. This is also combined. So again, both will have same, maybe same focal length, different focal length. So the ray of light will have to converge two times. First by first lens, let it be L1. Then by second lens, L2. So overall, the entire path of the ray of light will be affected. So again, this will behave as a single lens when they are placed together. So we can say this is also a combined lens of two convex lenses. Combined lens of two, one concave and one convex. And third possibility we can have is two different concave lenses are placed together. So again, a ray of light will first try to diverge, then will also try to diverge. Again, the ray of light will have a different pattern, different direction. So even this is L1 and L2, L1, L2. Or it is also possible more than two lenses can also be combined together. We can have concave, convex, 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 convex. So different lenses can be combined together. And now overall, these 2, 3, 4, 5 lenses which are placed together will behave as a single lens. And that single lens can overall all can behave as a convex, can behave as a concave. That depends on the focal length of the individual lenses. So that is what we have to understand here, combination of lenses. So I hope you understood this concept. So in general, if we say P1, P2, P3 are the power of lenses L1, L2, L3, then, so since the lenses will be combined together, so overall a combined lens will have a power. So overall power will be how much, that we can find out. Then the power of combined lens, I hope you understood the meaning of combined now, that is after combining all the lenses, what will be the overall power of the lens, that is called power of combined lens, will be P is equal to P1 plus P2 plus P3 and so on. So we just go on adding the power of the individual lenses, whatever will be the resultant power, that will be the power of combined lens. But always remember, this P1 can be of convex lens, P2 can be of concave lens, convex, concave, something like. So we have to do it according to this, that is we have to take care of the positive and negative as well. So for example, if power is positive, so we must take positive. If power is negative, we must take it negative, and then we need to add it together. So automatically the power can be cancelled, the power can increase, the power can decrease, all possibilities we have. So I hope you understood. If P1, P2, P3 and so on are the power of individual lenses, then the total power or the overall power of the combined lens will be just the sum of the power of individual lenses. So I hope you understood this much. Now if I say if F is focal length of combined lens, means after combining the lens, for example we placed one concave, one convex and one more concave, for example three different lenses we have placed together, and this will have some focal length f1 f2 f3. So this will have been negative, this will have been positive. Okay, so overall this will behave as the single lens, and this single lens will have a focal length, and that focal length can be positive or negative depending upon overall how they behave, is what is the focal length of individual lens. So if I say if F is the focal length of combined lens, that is overall power of the combination, then we can write down, in place of P we can write down 1 upon F, because P is reciprocal of focal length. P1 will be reciprocal of F1, if F1 is the power of the lens, plus reciprocal of lens 2, that is focal length, 1 upon F3 and so on. So this is just the formula, but when we are going to put the values, we have to take care of the positive and negative, because here we don't know which is positive, which is negative. So this is just a formula, And once we know which is concave and convex, we can put the values and we can get the answer. If overall, after addition, we get a positive value, then we can say the combined lens is behaving as a convex lens. If after combination, we are getting the focal length negative, means it is behaving as a concave lens. So that is how we have to apply. So we can use this formula or this formula to solve the numerical. So I hope you understood. So where F1, F2, F3 are the focal length of the individual lenses. So I've not written, but I hope you understood. So let's try some numerical. If one convex lens of focal length 100 centimeter and one concave lens of focal length 200 centimeter are placed together, what will be the power of combined lens? So with this numerical, we can understand the entire concept, how to apply the formula. So let's do it. So what is given? Very first, we have a convex lens, and one we have a concave lens. Focal length of this is given, let it be F1, how much? 100 centimeter, and now we know for a convex lens, we must take it positive. So this is 100 centimeter. And for concave lens, focal length is given 200, which must be negative, minus 200 centimeter. Now they are combined together, then what will be the power of combined lens? So what can be done? Either we first find the power of lens L1, let it be L1, and the power of L2, and then we can add it together. We can do that way, or we can directly put the formula of the power itself, sorry, the focal length itself to get the answer. So let's try both the method to get the answer. So I hope this part is clear. Now we don't need this part, it's already understood, the statement. So let's continue here. So very first, P1 will be 1 upon F1, and this is in centimeter, that is nothing but 1 meter. That's what I've taken in short so that you can understand properly. So this will be 1 by 1, that is plus 1 diopter. So there is no doubt, P1 will be 1 by F1, positive because it is a convex lens. P2 will be 1 by F2, and 200 means minus 2 meter only. So this will become minus 1 by 2 diopter, that is how much? 0.5. So minus 0.5 diopter. Therefore, power of combined lens, P1 plus P2. P1 is how much? Plus 1, so better use the bracket. Plus P2 is how much? Minus 0.5. And then add it together, so this will become 1 minus 0.5, that is 0.5 diopter, which is coming positive. So we can say we are combining the convex and concave lens, and after combination, the overall lens is behaving as a convex lens. So now after combining these two lenses together, if I place it together, the ray of light will finally converge after passing through both the lenses, because we are understanding from here, overall this will behave as a convex lens. That is the meaning of combination. So this is one method we have. We can go by this method, or we can apply direct formula also. So any method you can apply, but be alert. So we can apply second method, that is, we know 1 by F is equal to 1 by F1 plus 1 upon F2. So here we have only two lenses, that's why we have F1 and F2 only, we don't have F3, F4 and all. So this will be 1 by, so here you can put in centimeter because we'll get the focal length, and then we can finally convert that into power. So here it is how much, or better take it 1 by 1 plus 1 by 2 minus, okay, solve it. So be alert, here the focal length will come in meter only because I put the values in meter. So 1 minus 1 by 2, that is 1 by 2. So again we can see focal length we are getting positive, but this is 1 by F is equal to 1 by 2, which means F is equal to टू मीटर. ओके वाई टू बिकॉज वी आर फाइंडिंग वन बाय एफ. वाई मीटर बिकॉज वी हैव पुट द वैल्यूज फॉर फोकल लेंथ इन मीटर नॉट इन सेंटीमीटर. सो देयर फोर पावर ऑफ द कंबाइंड लेंथ विल बी वन अपॉन एफ वन बाय टू पॉइंट फाइव डायोप्टर. अगेन पॉजिटिव. So you can see answer is same. In the previous case also we got 0.5 diopter plus. Here also we are getting 0.5 diopter plus. Answer is same, method are different, but it's your choice which method you find the best one you can apply. But overall we understood this combined lens will behave as a convex lens. So rest numerically can try yourself and let's see if you are able to handle. Otherwise I'm here to help you in the numerical. So that's all we have today in the class, and we'll see if more numerical practice required. Otherwise, we can go for the next chapter. So, for today, it's done. Thank you. Take care and Hari Om.